In this video, we're going to work on problem 1.3.7 from the textbook. Let A be a real number that is greater than or equal to minus 1. Prove that 1 plus A to the n is greater than 1 plus n times A for all n in the set of all natural numbers. So again, we're going to use mathematical induction to prove this inequality. Okay, so we start with the base case for n equals 1. As you can see, the left-hand side is equal to 1 plus a to the first, and this is just 1 plus a, okay? And this can be written as 1 plus 1 times a, so this is exactly the right-hand side when n is equal to 1, okay? So the inequality holds when n is equal to 1. Okay, so now let's move to the inductive step. In the inductive step, we suppose that the inequality is satisfied when n is equal to k for some positive integer k. So suppose that 1 plus a to the k is equal to 1 plus k times a for some positive integer k. Okay, now we are going to use this inductive hypothesis to show that the inequality is satisfied when n is equal to k plus 1. Let us show that. One plus a to the power of k plus 1 is greater than or equal to 1 plus k plus 1 times a. Okay, and again we will try to show that the left hand side here is greater than or equal to the right hand side. Note that we are going to use the inductive step, the inductive hypothesis, that is 1 plus a to the k is greater than or equal to 1 plus k times a. Okay, so we have this. The left hand side here is equal to 1 plus a to the k plus 1, so it can be written as 1 plus a to the k times 1 plus a. Okay. Now, as you know, a is greater than or equal to minus 1. Therefore, 1 plus a here is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so this is a very important hypothesis. A is greater than or equal to minus 1. So a plus 1 again is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so now, as you know, 1 plus a to the k is greater than or equal to 1 plus k times a. This is the inductive hypothesis. So we can multiply both sides by 1 plus a, and then the inequality, the new inequality, is still satisfied. So we get this. So this is greater than or equal to 1 plus k times a, okay, times 1 plus a. Again, because 1 plus a to the k is greater than or equal to 1 plus k times a, so we can multiply both sides by 1 plus a, and then the new inequality here is still satisfied. So we get this. So, and now we can use the distributive law to multiply everything out. So now we get this 1 plus k times a, okay, and this is a, plus k times a squared, okay? This can be written as 1 plus k plus 1 times a plus k times a squared, okay? Note that k is in the set of all natural numbers, so it's greater than 0. And a squared for here, a is for any real number a, A squared is always greater than or equal to 0. Therefore, this term is greater than or equal to 0. Therefore, we end up having that this is greater than or equal to 1 plus k plus 1 times a. And this is exactly the right-hand side of the inequality that we want to prove. So, by induction, the given inequality is satisfied for all n in n. That is, 1 plus a to the n is greater than or equal to 1 plus n times a for all n in n. Okay, so we have finished the proof that 1 plus a to the n is greater than or equal to 1 plus n times a for all n in the set of all natural numbers.